So it's me again, Andrea. I'm going to start a new series on here where I talk about different papers that I have to write. This is basically going to be my version of free writing because I'm really bad at writing things down because I have ADD, and like it's hard for me to process things and then write them down. Like, I'll think of something, and like whenever it comes to write it down, like the thought is gone, you know? And I'm just an auditory learner too, and so like I keep looking at myself because I like to see what it, to make sure I'm in frame. But yeah, so today I'm going to be talking about Anna Karenina by Tolstoy. And the question that the paper is on is, are you supposed to condemn Anna or pity her? And I think that Tolstoy meant for us to pity her. Because though in the book some of the characters, like most of society and stuff, like, did condemn her and was like, you're a horrible person because you're openly, like, in an affair and stuff. And, yeah. But, like, if you're writing a book or any type of thing, if you want your character to be hated, you don't show their struggle. You don't make them look human. But that's exactly what Tolstoy did. He made sure that she was, that you saw her struggle and, like, you understood why she was making all these choices. And at the end of the book, whenever Levin, one of the characters, has, is talking about Faith and how he, was, like, deciding whether or not to kill himself, and he decided not to because he realized that he was thinking childishly and about his own desires, and that was the thing that a child would do. And we don't condemn children. Like, that's just a normal thing that you don't do. Like, yeah, we pity them because they're like, they don't understand things. And so we can't just be like, oh, you're a shitty person because they're a child, you know? And that's how Anna acts. Or Anna. I think it's Anna Karenina, actually. Sorry if that's annoying. But that's how she acts. She acts like a child. She doesn't understand love. She doesn't understand. She has some knowledge enough for an adult, but she doesn't have the emotional capacity for these things. Because with her relationship with Vronsky, it is very childish, and she just kind of, first she's just like flirting, like, oh, this will be funny, and then she's like, oh shit, now I'm in love, I want two husbands, because she kind of loved her other husband, because they had been together for a while, and had a kid, two kids, I think, actually, and, yeah, but then she immediately, to rationalize the fact that she was in love with Vronsky, she turned her mind away from Alansky, which was her husband, to, like, be disgusted by him and, like, hated every little thing that he did. And he didn't do much wrong. Like, they weren't a good fit for, like, life, I don't think. I feel like they would be good best friends. Like, whenever I was in the discussions, I was thinking that, like, they had more of a platonic love than, like, an actual, like, romantic love, because it was more out of respect and not out of, like, attraction. But her and Vronsky, it was so toxic to the point that she, like, threw herself under a train, and like, we're not supposed to think she did something good. We're supposed to feel sorry for her because, like, she became so overwhelmed and couldn't process everything and couldn't make herself happy or, like, get to a point where she could feel content with her life. Like, that wasn't gonna happen. And so she just killed herself. And you're not supposed to be like, oh, she's such a horrible person because she killed herself. Because no one was like that. No one said that. She just couldn't cope. And that was the reality of the situation for her. And yeah, that's what I'm gonna write about. And yeah. So I hope that was good enough for me, and I hope y'all enjoyed it. I'm gonna make this a series, so yeah. Whether you enjoy it or not, it's gonna happen. but yeah, I hope y'all liked it, and I'll see y'all next week, probably. Bye!